Sector 2, Uncle Sarge.
Where's the mystery man sending us this time?
Red Zone, Sector 2. Oh. Well, that's fine by me. I haven't been shot at in 2 days. Starting to feel a little edgy.
And you, I smell something.
How the hell does the Army think I'm gonna win the war when they give me 4 bozos like you to hold me down?
When do we get to meet this,
Popeye.
What the hell kind of name is Popeye for an intelligence officer?
Hey, now, wait a minute. He sends you guys out there on shit jobs because you happen to be the best that there is.
We just want to meet the man. We're not going to embarrass you.
Right, let's go.
I told you he was a class bunch, Sarge.
Maybe 3 minutes.
Ray, help pull the wire. Garrett, cover the front. I'll set the detonator.
This morning. Burned up a bunch of sofas, chairs, all because he didn't have the money.
The roller's done gone and up to ante again.
Yeah, they told me I gotta pay $50 a week now instead of $25.
Well, we're barely making it at the cafe now.
I know one thing, every dime I got is tied up in my laundromat.
It's the same for all of us, Earl. At least the punks, they never take everything.
It's not right what these gangs are doing.
What should we do?
We agree not to pay these gangs any more money. They can't beat up everybody.
But, Joe, when they come to collect the money, what do we do then?
We're going to drive the gangs out of the neighborhood. I mean, with what?
Our good intentions?
We're not soldiers, Joey.
Sound to me like we need to do some more thinking on this. This is the address. I've arranged the whole thing. It's a Smith & Wesson 38.
Are you sure this is right?
Go on, get out of here. It'll do you good.
Okay.
I love you, Bob. You sit next to a pretty girl on the bus for me, okay?
Hey there, Joe. Oh, look. Visitors.
Get out of here, lady. Move, goddammit.
Hey, Roboy. Look what I see.
Leave the woman alone, Roboy.
The story is, you're trying to stir up trouble. We can't have that. See what can happen to one of your customers?
I think I'm in love.
You bastards!
I go first. You hold it.
What's the matter, Jesse? You can't handle the foreplay.
Son of a bitch. Why'd you have to go waste a good piece of ass?
She pissed me off.
Now I'm gonna have to teach you a lesson.
Your time's coming, Roy Boy. You count on it.
The trouble is with people like you. You don't learn nothing unless it's pounded into your big, stupid head! Just pounded right into your stinking skull!
Somebody talk to me. I can't believe it. Two people are butchered in there in broad daylight, and nobody saw anything.
Talk? Why would anybody talk to you? When the punks are back on the street, they're gonna come looking for us.
All right. Let's get it wrapped up and get out of here.
Thank you for coming, Mr. Hecker.
Joe saved my life and now saved the whole squad. Listen, if there's anything I can do, please.
If you knew what they did to Joe.
Don't get caught up in it, Louis.
Well, people should know. They took a meat hammer to him and hit him again and again and again and again.
Sorry, sir. The circumstances of our meeting had to be like this.
You know, Joe talked about you so many times. He said that you taught him how to fight. You want to really do something for Joe. You teach us how to fight.
Police ain't gonna find them punks that killed Joe.
I only know the stories that Joe told about you in the war. We got nowhere else to turn.
Come on, Louis. Let me take you in.
Popeye? Bill Ecker. Yeah, well, yeah, it has been a long time.
No, I'm in Atlanta. Listen, you got a minute? I want to call in a couple of favors.
Marla. You know I got to do this, don't you?
We have a son now.
Jonas, he saved my life. I wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for him.
What about little Garrett's life?
I'll be back.
I love you.
I love you too, baby.
Here he is.
Here they go.
Great to see you, man. Great to see you. Sorry.
Look, I really feel bad. I didn't think you'd give up your job for this.
Well, now, who wouldn't want to give up the many life-threatening hazards of the accountancy business for the security that you guys are offering? Look, I do have just this one last case to get rid of, and it'll only take a second. And then I'm all yours, okay?
How's it going, brother?
Excuse me.
Sarge. Flashman Garrett. What's up?
Okay, the next few days we're gonna need to just check things out. Then I've got to get all the people in the neighborhood together so they could talk to us, meet us. Can that be arranged?
You bet. Get started right away. Come on, Louis.
Oh, Bill. Thanks.
Well, good day, Mr. Walker. You don't make your loan payments, you're gonna get hurt.
Ain't got nothing in there but this TV.
Oh, we'll take it.
Hey,
someone who's gonna feed us information.
These are the Scorpions. They're into strong arm stuff and deal weapons. The Turks run most of the gambling and prostitution.
Roy Boy Jagger and the Rollers.
So, how many gangs are you talking about altogether?
Well, three that control 90% of the action.
Signal. Three sharp raps in a row. It's a call for help. It's also a sign of our unity. We're all in this together. Whenever you hear this, you all join in, okay?
Garage, all these dudes started picking up wrenches and pipes and started tapping on the floor.
That's the same thing that happened to me and CC.
I mean, what the hell is going on?
You want to fuck with us? We'll fuck with them.
Name's Lieutenant Hawkins.
How you do?
I'm told you fellas are new to the neighborhood.
Yeah, on vacation.
Well, you're a long way from the beach.
Look, Lieutenant, we're just here visiting an old friend. Not looking for any trouble.
You know, the fact of the matter is, that's my job. Looking for trouble. You see, somebody does something they're not supposed to be doing, no matter how right they think they are. That's trouble. You know, I hate people thinking they know the law better than the police. I know you from somewhere.
Oh, well, do you follow the pro shuffleboard tour?
Anybody here know these men? Huh? Any of y'all ever seen them before?
Lieutenant Hawkins, Captain wants to see you.
Oh, Hawkins. Close it. Take some advice. Don't go trying to win a medal so they'll have to kiss your ass downtown. It doesn't work that way.
Well, I guess you're talking about my idea that you've got vigilantes operating in South Point.
You know as well as I do how the press loves to jump on even a hint of that kind of talk. I suggest you keep your theories to yourself and stick to collaring the punks responsible for that double homicide. Now get out of here.
Get a hold of him. Tell him we're ready.
Hey, dude. Hey, what's happening? So who are these new cats? Pissing up my neighborhood.
Never seen them before, man. They just blew in. Started pushing and shoving.
You make them out for any kind of heat?
Nah, they ain't no cops. They're something else, though. They're like the Four Musketeers.
Hey, that's good. Now, you know, I've been looking out for you guys, because in a couple of years, you're gonna be rollers. So next time these Musketeers pop up, I want you to let me know, okay? Just remember that I'm the guy that's looking out for your future.
Hey. You got it, man.
All right.
Come on in. Everything's clean. We're all set to pick you up.
Well, I'd say all in all, we gained a lot of ground, but we're still not one red curly hair closer to whoever wasted Joe than the day we got here.
Look, I know we all want to even the score for what they did to Joe, but I think cleaning out the gangs, which is what he wanted, what he died for, is more important right now.
Well, they're pretty well dug in here.
Yeah, well, the gangs are here because it's profitable. Now, somebody's making big bucks.
Sounds like you come up with something.
Well, I don't have the whole picture yet. But there's a big operator in Colombia making drug runs through here.
You know, I mean, these gangs may be some nasty little turds, but I really don't think they're into big league drugs.
Yeah, well, you're partially right, Ray. They're not on the inside. You see, South Point is only a warehouse for this combine on a Bogota. The gangs, they're paid for protection and cover. That way the people from the combine aren't here. What do you think would happen if one of their shipments got lost?
So, let's kick them in the pocketbook.
Where do we start?
We start with the rollers, the Turks, and the scorpions. We eyeball them day and night, find out exactly how they do it, everything.
In the neighborhood, thought I'd drop in for a cup of coffee.
Okay. Tell me the truth. You come here for the atmosphere.
Actually, you're right.
I don't understand. You've always got a bottle.
I'm sorry. It bothers you.
What should you care if it bothers me or not? I just don't like to see you with that stuff all the time.
Hey, look what I got!
Oh, not my book! No, that's my book! No!
Oh, no! Oh, leave her alone!
Leave her alone!
Hey!
here. Beat it, punk.
You see that?
I know who did it.
Who did what?
I know who killed your friend. I saw him do it.
Let's tail him. Fast. What are you waiting for? Us around the backside, Doc.
All those pus poles are in there together. No reason not to take them out right now.
What about the Sarge?
You never get a better shot at them.
Let's do it, brothers. I'll go high.
Well, this is as good a place to start as any. Okay, guys, you know what to do. Come on, gas it down. Give me a couple of them.
Say, man, the dude that owns this place, how much is he paying us?
5 big ones.
Yeah, well, let's burn this fucker. Good.
Guys, okay?
Where the hell were you, big boy?
Sorry, I got pinned down by shotgun.
Could have been too bad if someone stopped off on Martini.
Come on.
But Gertie ID'd him. These are the guys that hit Joey.
That's right. Same bunch we saw on the dope run. God damn it, we should have had him.
We would have. If Slick didn't have to stop her for the happy hour.
That's enough, damn it. Now, I may have some problems, but when it comes to you guys, I don't fuck around.
All right, knock it off, the both of you.
I don't believe this.
You guys ride into town like a bunch of cowboys about to shoot up Main Street, and you wonder why it all fell apart.
Okay, look. I'm glad we got a fix on who hit Joey. But he died trying to get this neighborhood get back on its feet. Now, if we don't have a plan to finish what he started, we're not helping him at all. Agreed?
Yeah.
We fucked up.
Sorry.
Okay. We have got to make a plan and follow it through. The next time these guys make a run, we're gonna be all over them. Ray, I want you to make a program to get that truck.
You want a Hogan's Alley? The whole shot?
The whole shot.
Woody, give me a hand mapping this thing out.
Right behind you, Ray.
Sarge, listen. I try not to say anything. You really think we can pull this thing off?
Hey.
I mean, with a wino in our squad.
He's coming along.
Really?
He was a hell of a soldier, and now, and from what I see around here, we can use every brother we got.
pull this off, we need to stop the chase cars. Now, I figure this is perfect for Hogan's Alley. What do you think?
Yeah, we could make a good Hogan's Alley out of this.
Any trouble setting up traps, Ray?
No. I foresee no problems whatsoever.
Doug.
Bastard, broke copper, save the kid.
Crazy. As hero.
Come on, guys, give me. Let's go, let's go. The high beast force, please.
Of course.
Yeah, go ahead, Boone. I copy.
I didn't think Roy Boy was going to shoot anybody.
Yeah, well, they pissed him off.
Lieutenant, Boone says he's got bodies shot up all over the alley. They're local gang members.
Time to kick a little ass. I think I know whose ass to start with.
Come on, move it. Come on, let's go. Get in there.
Nice job, Huggins.
Thanks.
I don't know. Maybe I was wrong, losing Ray that way. Maybe I pushed this thing too far.
No. They pushed it too far when they killed Joe.
Got to see this whole thing through.
You guys sure? Hey, Neil, how'd it go?
Everything squared away. You're free to go. I don't think you're going to have any more problems. They're going to have a hell of a false arrest suit if anything happens like this again.
Hawkins, do us all a favor. Next time, have some evidence before you book somebody.
I couldn't get a peep out of anyone on the street.
So what else is new?
Okay, one more time. Forklift.
Guard car.
Driver, out. Hogan's Alley.
Barrels. Back here, regroup.
You know, Ray set it up real good.
Yeah. I'm still worried about not having anybody up high.
It would have been Ray.
Yeah.
You're right. Working it out. Going in slow. That's how we used to do it. You used to do it great.
The best.
Yeah, we sure as hell did, didn't we?
Is that my chicken?
I just talked to the candy man. He wants us to ride shotgun for a load of dope he's running through tomorrow.
Man, what is his problem? He's all set up for tomorrow.
This load is bigger than usual.
Oh, yeah? How big?
5 times what we usually get.
Really? We're gonna do it a little differently this time. I want you to get us another set of wheels and make sure Doc brings a van.
Gotcha.
Driving the catering truck.
You got me. How's Bill?
the hell grabbed the catering truck?
Hold out Harry.
Hold out Harry?
Holy shit.
What is it?
Heroin. There's got to be millions of dollars worth here. No way this is a normal dope drop.
That's why they had that other car.
There's gonna be a lot of mad punks around here.
Mad as bees, and we're sitting on their honey.
Okay. Woody, you and I are gonna go back to Auburn Street and check things out. Garrett, stay here and make sure nobody tailed us looking for the truck. Let's go.
I just came past Sycamore Street. Something's going on. There's a couple dozen punks gathered down there.
Mr. Ecker here was just explaining it all to us. Seems our heroes here have gotten a hold of some property that belongs to somebody else.
Don't make it sound so dignified. It's drugs.
Heroin, to be exact. Lots of it. These gangs have been protecting big shipments coming through South Point.
And for this, you want me to fight?
No. To protect yourself.
There's an easier way out of all this. You just give them back what you took.
And just give up. We'd be worse off than when we started.
Come on, folks. This is no kind of life we've been living here, full of terror and fear. There's one thing clear to me now. We're going to change things around here. We're going to have to do it ourselves.
Somebody has got a truck. That's mine. I want it back.
What do you make?
Hard to tell.
You people wait, the hotter it's gonna get.
I'm going up on the roof. Get Garrett, get back here as quick as you can. Cover the road.
All right, Sergeant.
Louis, listen. Try to keep everybody inside, okay?
No matter what, count on us.
Thanks.
All right!
Where are you going?
I'm gonna go out there and I'm gonna talk to him. It's never too late to make a deal.
You crazy fool. You can't go out there.
We'll see who the fool is.
Come on. Let's hold it now.
Where the hell's my truck?
I don't think that any of this is gonna be necessary.
I want my truck. Now!
I'm not sure where it is, but I can get it for you.
You dumb mother! What am I talking to you for?
You almost burned me with that thing. Some mother's on the roof!
You stupid mothers! You gotta pay for this! Bring out the gasoline.
They're gonna know we're here.
I mean, everybody. See that school bus? Grab that fucker and bring it right here. Now, move, pronto!
Again, you bring my truck out here, or I'm gonna start throwing out dead kids.
He'll do it.
Yeah, he will.
Yeah. He's gonna be taking care of our future.
Garrett! Get that truck over here, quick!
Coming right up!
Hey. You're a real cutie, aren't you, huh? Yeah.
Bring in the truck now.
And get it out here.
Look, why don't you let the kids go first?
I ain't bargaining with you, you motherfucker. Just get it out here.
Yeah.
For a shitty little cripple. Oh, you stupid bastard. Get this whole area closed off. Is this hot? In there.
Let's go, Slick.
I guess you boys haven't been properly introduced. Meet Holdout Harry.
What the hell? You the one that took the dope truck?
Well, that's not much of a welcome. I thought you guys always wanted to meet Popeye.
Popeye from now?
You get it.
You're the son of a bitch used to send us all over hell to do your dirty work.
And here we are, doing it again.
Well, sometime even a cop gets fed up and the system falls apart.
Yeah, and we cleaned out some bad apples for you.
No, not for me, for those people down there, for this neighborhood.
Well, yeah, but it all works out. I mean, he gave us a lot of protection so we could get the guy that killed Joey.
Well, listen, guys, I'm afraid we gotta get out of here, you know?
Showtime?
Right.
Jesus Christ, Captain. That's gotta be the biggest load of heroin I've ever seen. Must be worth 5-10 million on the street.
It's got to be what this street war was all about.
Yes. We just made the police commissioner a very happy man. Lieutenant, what the hell are you doing?
These are the men behind all this.
Hawkins, I don't think you understand what's going on here.
Just ask some of your witnesses, Captain.
I'll tell you. I'll tell you what's going on. These gangs are finally killing one another off. Something you police should have been doing all along.
The punks have another shootout. And you're trying to arrest innocent citizens.
You know, officer, I think you fellas should be glad that nobody was badly hurt while these punks are down here having their fight.
Hawkins, let him go.
Let him go?
You heard me, Lieutenant.
But, Captain...
Turn him loose. What we got here is one big drug bust. And with this gang war, there's a lot fewer punks down here to cause any more trouble. Don't complicate things with any more of your vigilantes talk. You know, we were able to solve this one without you. Maybe it's time you went back to Metro.
Well, it looks like you got what you were after, Captain. Looks like everybody did.
Is everyone all right?
Yeah, I think we're okay. How are you?
Fine. I really don't know what to say. I guess, thank you.
You know, this could be a nice, quiet neighborhood again. I was thinking about sticking around and helping to keep it that way.
I think I'd like that. Can I buy you a cup of coffee?
Yeah. Give me a minute, okay?
Okay.
Thank you, guys. Thanks for turning me around.
Hey, man. War is finally over.
The battle, maybe. Not the war.